Transposable elements, which are found in virtually all cells, are segments of DNA that can move from one location in the genome to a target sequence in another. A simple type of transposable element called an insertion sequence, or IS element, is only 700 to 1500 base pairs long and consists of two basic parts: a coding region for an enzyme called transposase and two short inverted repeat flanking sequences. The cellular machinery transcribes the transposase coding region and translates it into the transposase enzyme. Transposase catalyzes the transposition process. The transposase randomly selects one of many possible target sequences where it will move the insertion element. The IS element, depending on the particular type, may enter the target sequence by one of two general mechanisms: replicative transposition or non-replicative transposition. In replicative transposition, transposase nicks the transposable element and the nicked ends attack the target sequence, making a staggered cut in the target DNA. DNA polymerase fills in the large gaps and DNA ligase seals the remaining nicks. A recombination event resolves the two molecules. As a result of replicative transposition, the cell has a copy of the transposable element flanked by duplicated target sequences. Non-replicative transposition is sometimes called cut-and-paste replication. In this process, transposase brings inverted repeats and flanking DNA together. One phosphodiester bond is cleaved on each strand at opposite ends of the IS element, yielding free 3' OH groups. Each 3' OH end attacks the other strand of the double helix, creating a new bond that results in hairpin structures. Host carrier DNA is ejected, and the hairpins on the IS element are re-nicked and attack target DNA. From the 3' hydroxyl groups, the cell's DNA polymerase molecules fill in the gaps, and DNA ligase seals the remaining nicks. In this way, the element jumps from one DNA molecule to another. To summarize, in non-replicative transposition, the transposable element is cut and pasted from one DNA molecule to another. In replicative transposition, the transposable element is copied to yield two transposable elements, one in the original position and one in the target DNA.